was just trying to figure out how the trowel got there.
Yeah, the mask tends to makes it bleed out a little bit more around the ears. Because it's dragging through it, you know. Especially if you have somebody in your chair that likes to fidget with it or is constantly talking and it's moving all over the place. I'm like, you gotta quit. You're not that bad.
No, that's the only side that did it at all on, so.
Tiny bit stretchy. The elasticity is not great. Means that between the color and the burn and the chlorine and the history and all that it's not in bad condition by any means. It's And the toners generally aren't damaging. They're usually ammonia free. So, is that about where it parks normally?
It normally parks in the middle for the most part, I'll be honest. Otherwise, funny parking today. Normally, it's straight down the middle. But then again, whenever they do my hair, they part it all different ways. So, I mean.
Well, this haircut, you kind of have to be sure.
Yeah. It's normally in the middle.
I'm tender-headed, so I'm going to apologize every time that I tug your hair.
I used to be tender-headed, and my head has gotten a little
tougher.
Like, I sometimes rough it off. It will hurt, but...
Damn, lady, how do you have any clients? They used to tell my best friend she was really heavy-handed. How do you have any clients, man? It's ridiculous. For new combs. I can't seem to find these combs anymore. I usually get them at Sally's, but I haven't seen any stuff.
Well, they're trying to watch all these YouTube videos on how to dye your hair.
Mm-hmm. Well, you can only buy these in like packs of 12.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Whoop. They're not my favorite, but if you're hold your comb and like your point cutting or whatever, sometimes you can cut into them a little bit and then they start hanging hair real bad and you're like, okay, I'm gonna throw that one away. Some people can work past it, I can. And again, that's gonna bother me for the rest of its life, so I'm gonna throw it away. Alright. So we are gonna start small, or not start small, but we're gonna start with the general shape. And I'm gonna do quite a bit of cutting now. But then I'm going to blow dry you and style you, and I'm probably going to do some more cutting after.
That's how it normally works, so you're fine.
So, the hair always acts differently when it's dry, and this is not, you know, it's not an easy cut. So you really have to read the hair when it's, what it's doing to make sure you blend, otherwise you get shells and crap that everyone wants to see. This one's choppier. Okay, so chin, all the way down to your chest.
Perfect.
Thank you. like the front end to end? Well, and it'll shrink up a little bit when it's dry. A lot of this is coming out with the scalp in the way.
Yep. Actually, I think you can take it up a little bit further in the front.
Okay.
If you want. And then you can go a little bit shorter to the back. I'm just thinking, I'm like, let's go chin. I'm just trying to think of coolness factor. It's hot. And I have a lot of hair.
gonna shrink up a little bit.
Yeah.
Feeling good there?
Yeah.
And of course, with some fluffing and layering, it's gonna. No, it bothers me.